Welcome to the Dam Owner Academy, brought to you by the Association of State Dam Safety Officials, or ASDSO, a series of videos to educate and inform on all aspects of operating and maintaining a dam safely. This video will cover problems with concrete and concrete repair techniques used on dams. Concrete is a common building material used in the construction of dams. It's a composite material of aggregates, cement, and water that hardens over time into a solid and durable substance, and often includes internal steel reinforcement. Many dams are built entirely of concrete, but even earthen or rock-filled dams often have appurtenant structures made from concrete. Although it's usually tough and long-lasting, concrete can experience problems like any other building material. And, given the consequences of failure, dam owners must be familiar with the specific issues that can arise on concrete structures. This video provides an overview of common problems with concrete at dams and some techniques that can be used to make repairs. Construction errors are the first class of problems with concrete. If concrete isn't mixed and placed correctly, it won't perform as intended and may not last as long as expected. Some errors can be resolved before they occur by having a qualified inspector on site during construction who can review batch tickets, oversee placement, and perform quality control testing of the materials. Two common construction errors that can be visually observed are honeycombing and bug holes. Honeycombing is recognizable from exposed coarse aggregate on the surface of a concrete structure with no surrounding mortar. This problem is usually caused by insufficient vibration or a poor concrete mix. Bug holes are small holes on the surface of concrete caused by a poor mix or excessive vibration during placement. Both issues can reduce a structure's durability over time by allowing moisture into the concrete, where it can freeze and deteriorate the material. Another class of problems that concrete structures can face involves degradation of the material. When concrete deteriorates into small fragments, it's called disintegration. And when concrete flakes from the surface, it's called scaling. When more significant pieces of concrete degrade from a structure, it's often called spalling or pop-outs. Several mechanisms can lead to concrete degradation over time, including poor mix design, chemical attack, or physical impact by debris or vehicles. Another common cause of degradation is freeze-thaw damage. When the pore spaces within the concrete are saturated with water and exposed to freezing temperatures, the water in the pore spaces expands, damaging the concrete. Over time, repeated cycles of freeze-thaw can result in scaling, disintegration, or spalling. If any of these conditions expose the reinforcing steel within the concrete, structural problems can result. Efflorescence is another issue with concrete structures that results in a white, crystallized substance on the surface. Efflorescence is usually caused by water seeping through pores or cracks. When the seepage evaporates, it leaves behind minerals that have been leached from the soil or the concrete itself. It's usually not a structural problem, but efflorescence can indicate that drainage issues or cracks are present. Water seeping through concrete can also lead to corrosion of steel reinforcement and freeze-thaw damage. Concrete erosion is another issue that occurs from abrasion, usually due to flowing water that carries aggregate or debris. Erosion can also be caused by cavitation, which results from subatmospheric pressure within spillway or outlet flows. Concrete erosion and cavitation damage usually occur on protrusions into the flow, like at baffle blocks, offsets in joints, or near the crest of a spillway, where water pressures are low. Concrete erosion occurs on the surface of structures and may not warrant significant concern unless it involves severe pitting or exposes underlying reinforcing steel. The final issue faced by concrete is cracking. Some cracking is expected on all concrete structures, usually from shrinkage as the concrete cures. Minor cracking is generally not a concern for the structure's performance. However, some cracks can be a sign of distress. For example, alkali aggregate reactivity is a serious condition that occurs when the raw materials within concrete react with each other over time, leading to cracks and expansion of the concrete. Also, structural cracks that extend deeper into the concrete can be a sign of settlement or overstressing. Regular inspection and monitoring are essential to detect problems with concrete materials before they lead to major issues. Inspect concrete structures at least once per year and after any significant storm events. Written records and photographs will help you track and monitor any issues as they evolve, allowing you to repair problems before they lead to a structural failure. For further information on this topic, see our video on dam inspections. Before making any repairs to concrete, it's essential to rectify the cause of the damage first to prevent it from occurring again in the future. A professional engineer should be retained to provide guidance and design during repairs of significant movement, damage, cracks, or undermining of concrete structures. Next, we'll discuss some techniques that can be used for minor concrete repairs. Small holes in new concrete can be filled using the dry pack method. A dry pack mix usually consists of 1 part cement, 2.5 parts sand, and enough water to create a thick paste that can be packed into the defects. If large areas of concrete are damaged, the area may need to be replaced. First, any unsound concrete is removed by sawing or chipping, then the area is cleaned. Next, new reinforcing steel is added to the repair area and tied to the existing steel if required. A bond coat or bonding agent should be applied to the existing structure to facilitate adhesion with the new concrete. Finally, new concrete can be placed into the damaged area. A professional engineer can provide guidance or details for major concrete replacement works. Another technique, called pre-placed aggregate concrete, is used for mass concrete repairs. This process involves removing the deteriorated concrete, repacking the repair area with clean, washed, coarse aggregate, then pressure grouting the voids in the repair area with a specialized grout of sufficient flowability. This technique is particularly useful for underwater repairs to piers and abutments. Synthetic materials are another option available to repair damaged concrete that consist of polymers or epoxy resin. Synthetic patch compounds can be used to fill damaged areas, and epoxy can be injected into cracks to stop the flow of water. When the epoxy cures, it creates a strong bond between the crack sections. Another method for repairing cracks is a urethane sealant, which can be applied to cracks to reduce the flow of water. This technique doesn't form a structural bond, but it can be used on cracks that are still active because the material is flexible. Be sure to follow the manufacturer's recommendations when installing synthetic patches and crack repair solutions, as the steps can vary between products. Understanding the causes of problems and techniques for repairing concrete can help you maintain the integrity of your dam and its appurtenances over its lifetime. Delay in minor repairing of concrete structures can lead to further degradation, corrosion of steel reinforcement, and even structural failure. As always, consult with a qualified professional engineer for any significant issues related to your dam or if you need technical guidance with a concrete structure. In addition, the Association of State Dam Safety Officials has free resources available to help owners operate and maintain their dam safely. Contact your State Dam Safety Program for additional help and be sure to check out ASDSO's website at damowner.org for more information.